Welcome, fellow knights. It's Pixelated Alpalo. Thanks for stopping by. I hope you guys are doing well, and I hope you guys are ready for this battle. I really don't think you are. I think this battle will be too much for you. I could be wrong, but this is a really good fight, so make sure you have your snacks and drinks, you have a very comfortable place to watch this, and of course, you're holding on to your butts, because this is going to be a very crazy fight. This is an excellent battle replay, and the ending is fantastic, so get ready for a good one. So in today's scenario, we have three orc armies in Mountain Pass. They have surrounded the elves. We have two elven armies. One is the high elves, and the other army is the sylvan elves. Jackie Fish is commanding the sylvan elves. I am commanding the high elves, and our backs are to the walls, so we have to stand our ground, take on this massive horde. So I love doing these kinds of scenarios where one side, the side that has the least amount of players, they take a defensive position, and the other team, they just have to storm in and take out that defensive position. So it's kind of like a siege, but without the siege settlement. So yeah, it's gonna be awesome. Also, we have less gold, the defenders. We have 25k, and the attackers have 35k. So they have more troops, and they have more money. And I think there's more than 13,000 troops on the battlefield right now. So this is going to be a huge fight. So let's go ahead and look at the army comps and then get this one underway because it starts right away. We will start with the attackers. We have Mordor here, commanded by Prince of Kingdom of Fluffy Duck. He has some spears in the back. He's got some Uruks and some Black Numenoreans with the general in it. He's got some trolls, two units of trolls back here. And then he has some orc raiders as his secondary line, just a massive force of orcs. And then he's got Orc Band in the front line. So now moving on to the next army, we have Isengard, which is one of the nastiest evil factions in this game. He's got some raiders, he's bringing some wargs, very nice fast-moving cav there. He also has some infantry and some pikemen in the back. He's split up his army, so he has forces going up this ramp. So he's got some more infantry. I think he's got two berserkers, guards of Orthanc, and he also has a catapult and some crossbows. You can see he's gonna quickly march and try to take the very strategic position here, but Jackie Fish, he's gonna push up his spears and try to hold this very narrow choke point. Moving on to the very last attacking army. Again, we have Mordor commanded by Son of Imladris. He's bringing some orc band in the front line, very similar to the other armies. He has some Uruk halberds and a ballista, which is going to be very accurate, very deadly. And back here, he has more Uruks, and he has some cave trolls in the back as well. And I think he's got some Olag Hai, which is a force to be reckoned with, a very deadly cav, or not cav, but troll force. And then here's his Black Numenoreans with the general in it. So again, very similar to the other Mordor army. Let's go ahead and now look at the good guys, the goody guys. So over here, Jackie Fish is bringing some Sylvan Heavy Spearmen. He's got some Sentinels of the Woodland Realms, and he has some Sylvan Heavy Archers. Here is his general, the Sindar Archers, is a very deadly force there with the blue cloaks there. And then he's got some heavy swordsmen, he's got some woodland warriors with their great axes, he has a catapult, and he's got a couple units of sylvan spearmen. So now moving on to my high elves, I have two units of Eldar Enwë's spearmen, I was going to say swordsmen, and then I have three units of the Linden Longspears, and I have two units of the Eldar Enwë swordsmen. Up here, I've got some archers, so I've got two units of the warrior archers. Not sure how to pronounce it, so I'm not even going to try. Now, unfortunately, I pressed start before I was properly deployed, so most of my army is stuck in the mountains, so I need to quickly get them back down and support this main fight that's going to happen in that valley down there. But really, the rest of my army, I've got one cav unit, I've got two units of Sword Quindi, I have two units of the Mithlin Nobles, and I have a ballista. And that's pretty much it from my army. It's not huge, but hopefully it gets the job done. And you know, at least I got some troops down here to defend this area, so they're gonna buy us some time as I get the rest of my army in position. You can see I'm moving up my archers on this cliff, getting a very good view. And you can also see that they are not moving forward. So this is fantastic. They're taking their time, which gives me more time to set up my forces. And I'm pushing up my spears to defend this narrow choke point here. So really, this is a battle of choke points, even though it seems like there's a lot of open ground. All right, so here we go. Jackie Fish forming up his Sylvan Heavy Shield, Spearmen, but they are going to form a shield wall and take on whatever comes through this valley. Whatever comes through this valley, we will stand our ground. So this is a fight or die situation. So you might as well fight, because if you don't, you'll die. So he's got two rows of spears. I like it. Can he form a shield wall? I think so. Yeah, there's a little bit of lag here, guys, because of all the troops on the battlefield. Hopefully it kind of calms down after a while once some of the troops start dying. But Isengard, commanded by Untamed Wolf, he's going to go ahead and charge in. The spears are inching forward, ready to take on Isengard. And look at that. He's trying to be extra sneaky here, trying to go around the flank. But thankfully, Jackyfish has another row of spears to hold them back. And now the pikes are moving forward. They're getting shot to pieces, though. They're going to look like Swiss cheese pretty soon, because all these sentinels of the Woodland Realm putting down a lot of firepower. So this is an excellent spot for Jackyfish. He's going to rack up a lot of kills. But this is exactly what we have to do in these kinds of situations, because look at that balance of power. It is way in their favor. So we got to rack up tons of kills. We got to hold these strategic choke points, or we're going to lose. There's no way we're going to turn this one around. So we'll see what happens. So great, great fight going on here. So what we're going to do is head back over to the other side, see what's going on here. You can see that they're still marching forward. They still are just taking their time. They're finally charging forward. Actually, it says they're marching. They're not running. But they're marching pretty quick. It's a pretty scary sight, because I wanted to have some archers to support me. Thankfully, Jackyfish has his Sylvan Heavy archers close by, so he's going to send them forward, get them in position, and support my spearmen, who are in shield wall formation, which could be a bad thing, because I've got two big gaps. I might need to spread out a little bit. Over here, I'm doing the same thing, forming shield wall. They're having a little bit of a difficult time because there's a rock in the way, and they're like, what do we do? I don't know. This wasn't in the training. I don't remember. They didn't teach us this. So they're just kind of lost, walking around this rock, just trying to figure out how to form up. And then, of course, I've got my spears ready to go in the back. I'm quickly sending more spearmen around the flank here so I can send more troops to defend this area. But here we go. The troops are now beginning to charge. They're going up this hillside. And you can see he's already going to go for that gap there. So I need to quickly move my spears. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and tell them to charge in to pin these orcs back so they can't get around me and attack the archers. But unfortunately, that leaves a giant gap in this area as well. So not a great start. Not a great start for me, because I didn't deploy properly and most of my army is not supporting this main front line, which I wanted to get a ton of kills on this front line. So there he goes. He's just going to sneak on by. That's a very smart, wise decision to do. I'm going to try to charge in and try to get them both to attack me. And I'm kind of surrounded here. But again, I'm just trying to support these archers, buy them more time so they can fire more arrows. And you can see the archers back here. They are racking up tons of kills. All right, so let's head over to the juicier part of this battle, which is over here. You can see that they now committed some Olag High, trying to silence the archers. Jackyfish has sent up some woodland warriors with their great axes and that AP damage. Right, AP? That's what it's called. Armor penetrating, there you go. Yeah, AP damage. Had a brain fart there. So I don't know if that actually helps against trolls, like having armor piercing, but it's worth a shot. You might as well try. He also has some woodland warriors over on this side holding back so many Uruk-hai. And the pikes are close behind. The pikes are going to be a big issue here for these elves. I just love the scenery of the background of this battle. Like, the map really feels like a Middle Earth scenario, like a location in Middle Earth. So they're just pouring in more and more troops. See, they notice there's a pretty large gap over here. See, that's the number one issue of our defense so far, is just we're leaving these gaps in our lines, and the enemy is able to push more troops around and flank us a little bit there. But it looks like Jackfish, he has it under control. It's not that bad. Also, he needs to get his catapult in position. I think he's been trying to fire it, but there really hasn't been a good shot yet. So he's just waiting for the enemy to get a little bit closer, and just here's our bird's eye view. And look at, they're just pouring in like a river, trying to grow, trying to go around that flank there. Jakubis sending over some heavy swordsmen to clog up that gap, but so far it's been a shaky start for our elven boys, our elven side, the Elven Alliance, the last stand of the elves. All right, so over here on this side, you can see that we're now fighting on the front here. My spearmen are holding back the first wave. I've got the Linden long spears close behind. We're actually breaking the enemy, but remember, it's mostly orc band, so this is nothing to be proud of. In fact, it's inevitable for the orc band to break during this battle. And now I had to send in some of my swordsmen to the fight. I do have my cab finally showing up to save the day. And here comes, finally, my units are showing up from where they originally started. I'm just trying to quickly get them in position so I can continue to hold these strategic choke points. Jackyfish also has some spearmen joining me in this fight. So he's going to send up some support. I'm going to tell my Linden Longspears to hold their ground. Do not follow the enemy. Just stand here. But it looks like Jackyfish, he's eager. He wants to kill these dang orcs, so he's going to charge in and take on the orc raiders. So far, so good. I mean, we could have done a lot better, for sure. But I'm just happy that we're still holding these strategic positions and not giving them up. If we look over on this side, though, you can see there's a lot of trouble over here. Jackyfish's archers were getting cut down by the Urukai. I sent up, if you remember, I sent over that Linden Longspear unit. So now they're holding this strategic point right here. Jackyfish was able to save some of his archers. So he's going to go ahead and continue to fire here. They took a lot of casualties there. This unit's down to 35. This unit's down to 75. So this one's doing a little bit better. But they're going to continue to fire down and continue to get some kills. Linden Longspears are going to try to hold out as long as possible. And my archers are finally showing up here. So, yep, here's my archers. They're going to move down here and join the fight. And I also have my general. By the way, my general is in this Eldar Inway archer unit. They're charging down as well, trying to support the Linden Longspear. So what I'm going to do here is set them up on this slight slope over here and then fire down at the flank of the orcs who are trying to break through. Now he's committing trolls into this fight, which is a smart idea. It will disrupt my formation. Let's head over to Jackyfish's side because things are getting pretty crazy pretty quick. And just look at the horde of orcs over here. The insane amount of orcs just trying to push in. He sent up some spearmen, extra reserves. I don't know how long he can hold. He cannot give up this position though, because if he loses this position, then my two positions down below in the valley will be lost, because he'll be able to flank around. So insane amounts of troops in one area. Just kind of zoom out, give you a bird's eye view. Absolutely madness over there. He's still trying to set up his catapult crew. Unfortunately, some Uruks, a small group of Uruks, look at this, the unit has 165, right? They're just pushing through. Somehow, they push through this main battle line, got past the elves, and were able to silence this catapult. Unbelievable. Only in a battle that I'm playing in do we get this kind of luck. It is insane. So yeah, he's got like 5-6 troops over here silencing this catapult. Jackyfish definitely needs to send some support because he needs to get this catapult firing. If we head back over here, you can see my army is forming up on this side. Archers are now letting loose some arrows into the orc position. And my Linden Longspears are thinning out. They can only hold on for a couple more minutes probably. So I'm going to have to send in some support. So I've got my Sword Quindi. I have two units of Sword Quindi. They're now quickly marching over to that side to support them, because I cannot lose that flank as well. And then the fight over here is still going on. Pretty awesome. We're thinning out though. My Linden Longspears holding back these trolls. But I've got two units of swordsmen just ready to engage. Just holding back as reserve. But as soon as I start to feel like we need to send in more, I will charge them in. So these trolls are going to be a huge, huge issue for our forces down here. But we still have a lot of troops. My spearmen, unfortunately, charged out a little bit. They're in a very tricky situation. Not a good spot right here. You can see them kind of like branching down this way. So they're kind of surrounded around the orcs. The trolls are breaking through. I think pretty soon I'm going to have to send in my my swordsman here. Any moment now. I patiently wait. See more and more orcs coming in this way. Trying to take out my spearmen. Trying to break them down. Jackyfish still holding this side pretty well. Actually pushing them back. Look at that. Running downhill. Taking out some of these orc raiders. So we're still holding. There's still hope for us. There's a lot of hope for us. There we go. This is the charge. I just wanted to show you this. It looks so epic. Charging in. Reinforcements. My Linden long spears are thinning out over there. So now I'm holding him out with the swordsman. I had to run my cav out of there because he was focusing his snogger stalkers at my cavalry force here. So you can see I took a lot of casualties there. And my sword Quindi are now in position supporting my Linden Longspears, and we're holding back some Uruk-hai pikemen. This is a really good situation because I got a cheap unit holding back a very expensive unit, and I have archer support. So they're getting a lot of kills from the flank. If we move up here to the other side, seeing Jackyfish's situation, not good. Not good at all. He is crumbling. He is breaking. His lines are thinning. You can see Uruk-hai are slowly just breaking through these lines. You can see him trickling down here. Not a good sight there. Catapult still hasn't really gotten any good shots yet because of the weird positioning. It's going to make it, having friendlies in the way. Catapults are really iffy sometimes. If you don't have them in a really good spot, they just won't fire. They're really, really bad about that. So unfortunately, Jackyfish has not had any luck with that. And now he's just trying to quickly patch up the holes in this defense with his Sylvan Heavy Archers who've used up most of their ammo. But this is not good. Look at all the dead bodies too in this one area. It's been a one bloody fight over here. And the Isengard forces are just rushing in. They don't even care about their own lives. They're just going to pour on through and try to disrupt this elven defense here. But I don't know how much longer Jackyfish can hold out over here. And the balance of power not looking great. We've killed more, but only 3% more. We need to kill more if we're going to be able to win this battle. Oh, the catapults have loaded up here. The catapults are going to be able to get a shot off here. Here we go. It misses. Oh, there we go. Oh, my goodness. A lot of friendly fire there, though. But it actually broke some of the Isengard forces. So that was something. But now the orcs are going to be able to storm in and silence that catapult. Let's see if he can quickly get another shot here. He's got one loaded up. Got to be faster. Come on. One more shot. One more shot. They're charging in. Are they going to be able to pull it off? I don't think so. It's going to take too long. They take forever to load and fire this damn thing. Nope. They're silenced. And the catapult is lost. And I told Jackyfish, get out of there. Just retreat. Fall back. It's red alert. Red alert at this moment in time. And you can see I'm now falling back my Mithlin nobles. I was going to use them aggressively to defend over in this area. Now all the troops that are left fighting here must fight to the death because we have to fall back. Too much. I realized that there's no way we could win this battle defending so many different spots. So we have to fall back to a single spot together where me and Jackyfish can defend against these great armies of Mordor and Isengard. You see the berserkers are now in the fight as well. And unfortunately his spearmen are breaking. They lack discipline. They don't want to die for their people. My poor swordsmen here are getting surrounded by all kinds of different creatures. Monsters that come from the nether. Yeah, our defense is crushed over here. Ironically enough, though, my sword Quindi are victorious. So they defeated, look at that, they're running for their lives. They defeated whatever Isengard sent us, but I have to pull them back because they can get surrounded from the forces coming down this way. So I have to retreat them. They deserve to be retreated and to fall back and defend the more strategic position. I'm really, really proud of my Sword Quindi. They did an excellent job. So good job, guys. You will get extra turkey legs if you survive this battle. Probably okay, so now Jackie Fish, he's got some of his troops. They return from breaking, but it's not like the spearmen are going to really do anything, so he might as well use them as a sacrifice unit. Yep, nope, they're breaking. Oh, here comes my Cav, though. Speaking of ultimate sacrifice, Cav going in, trying to slow down the pursuing orcs. Nice. Excellent, excellent charge there. I took out a ton of orcs. I'm going to fall back. So I realize that the Cav here is not going to be very helpful in this defensive position. There's not going to be open ground where I can get cycle charges, so I might as well use them as effectively as I can right now. But they will make the ultimate sacrifice right here, right now. So actually, let me pause it. They deserve some special sad music right here. So let's go ahead and enjoy this glorious charge. They deserve that. They deserve that because they knew they were not going to come out of this alive. They're charging in, risking their own lives to buy more time for the rest of the Elven defenders to set up a nice defensive position. Rest in peace, great Eldar Inwë Lancers. And I'm actually now firing some arrows down into their position. The Warg Riders are going to run past those Elven Cav units there. They're going to continue to pursue our forces. You can see we haven't really properly set up over here, but we're going to defend this right here, this line that you see my mouse is going over. We're defending that right there. It's just one fairly large choke point, and they actually get a pretty good charge on the back of my men. I tell my warriors here to turn around. These guys have actually used up all their ammo. Look at that. Look at that. Look at, he's just mowing down my troops. That is insane, those wargs. They actually did something useful there. So yeah, look at that. They just, oh my god. Evaporating my troops there. And we thankfully kill those wargs. Now I can properly set up my defenses. I'm retreating my Sword Quindi. Most of them made it back over there. My Cav, they're breaking. They're getting out of there. So not all of them died, but most of them did. There goes a charge from his general. Really gutsy move there from the Prince of the Kingdom of Fluffy Duck. He's going to fall back, though. I'm focusing a lot of my arrows down on this general because we have to kill the generals if we're going to turn this one around. And look at the balance of power. 64 to 67. We've actually lost more than they have. Now, we did kill a lot of quality troops like trolls and pretty elite infantry. But we still have a lot to do, but we still have a decent amount of ammo and a decent amount of solid infantry. We also have my ballista, which is going to be very, very useful at this point of the battle. But here comes the first wave. They are not even going to take a breather. They're just going to keep pushing. They're not going to let us set up camp here. And I've got somewhat of a sturdy line here of Mithlin nobles. Unfortunately, this unit, a lot of them died to the wards that charged in. They're at 63. Here comes the orcs. Here comes Mordor. This unit's got 121. They're a lot healthier here, taking on some Uruk. Or no, those are spearmen. So this is the fantastic last stand of the elves. There's nowhere else to go. This is it. We either die here or some of us fight and survive it. Oh, and then we got a ballista firing down. Isn't that fun? So not only are we outnumbered, we're also outgunned. They have a ballista and they have a catapult that's going to be able to fire down. He finally got some friendly fire though, but he's not going to get a lot because ballistas are just so dead accurate. Yeah, look at that. It's chewing up our back lines. But we're actually breaking his orc raiders here. It's a fantastic sight. A huge chunk of his forces are breaking. We do have some trolls in the front line as well. And they're really, really trying to push on this flank here. You can see they're trying to get through this small gap. They've been doing it all game today, all battle. They're going for my ballista that's formed up on this slope here, just trying to find a good angle to hit the enemy. I got archers set up here. I believe this is my general. Let's see. Yes, that's my general. You can see him right here giving out orders. Come on, elves. You got this. Aim. Fire. Kill them all dead. You see some of his infantry actually is engaging my ballista crew. That's not good. I need to free them up so I can fire my ballista. My warriors here now firing down. They got a pretty good angle. This is, I only have two more. I think I have three units of archers that have ammo left over. The balance of power still in their favor by 1%. Ooh, and that ballista just chewed up my archers over here. I need to get them in loose formation. More arrows coming in. We're actually fighting some berserkers down here. Got a unit of 47 berserkers. We're just focusing all of our arrow fire on that one unit because berserkers are the most threatening unit on the battlefield right now. The elves are holding. And they continue to hold. Oh, then here comes that ballista taking out so many of my precious, precious Mithlin nobles as they fight the berserkers. Massive chain route from the orcs, though. You're going to get that a lot. The orcs lack discipline. Oh, and the catapult coming in, roasting a lot of the elves there. That was, my heart sank. I was so sad at that. I was just like, what are we supposed to do? What are we supposed to do against those catapults? Jackfish is running down a lot of archers. We're getting more troops to hold this front line. The berserkers, unfortunately, have been tearing up my Mithlin nobles, along with the ballista, relentless fire coming down, trying to take out my archers. My archers are going to continue to fire, though, stand their ground, even though they're getting shot at, getting picked apart by that ballista. Now we see a general running by, so we're going to focus fire on that general. Just trying to get lucky, trying to snipe him out. Unfortunately, he's going to get to safety. This front line is looking rough. You see they got more and more forces coming in. The balance of power, it's still in their favor, but it's kind of inching in our favor. We'll see what happens. But you can see they're really pushing with this Orc Raiders. I'm now sending in my swordsmen to reinforce that side. And that ballista still going to town. Finally, I get my men into loose formation. Jackyfish sending in some Sindar archers. Oh, another catapult shot there, taking out a lot of elves. Amazing. See, with the catapult, sometimes it's a good thing that they're using their catapult because they could potentially get a lot of friendly fire, but so far, they've mostly killed our elves. Not a good thing. Not a good thing at all. Alright, so now he's got his troops lined up over here. Very strange formation there, but I am going to fire my ballista at that huge chunk of troops. My archers here, what are they doing? I guess they're whole. I think I'm saving some of my ammo. Come on, ballista, keep up the fire. Keep killing those orcs. Let's see. There we go. Yep, we got another shot coming down. I'm actually getting some pretty good shots at this point. You can see arrows coming down, just trying to focus down on that blob over there. Here comes another ballista round. Oh, yeah! Fantastic. Took out like 10 there. But here comes enemy returning fire. More breaking. The elves cheer as they see another horde of orcs breaking, fleeing for their lives. But more fires coming in, taking out a lot of our elves here. Not a good sight. The balance of power getting close to even. It's still in favor of the orcs. Still anyone's game. But we need a miracle here. The last stand of the elves. Most of the berserkers have been killed. Here comes another wave of spearmen from Mordor as they take on the Sindar archers. We got more troops coming in this way as well. Oh, the ballista gets a pretty good hit there, but only killing one of the orcs. More arrows coming down. Wipe them out. Wipe them out. Here comes a general now. Again, we're going to change our fire, our focus fire on the general. I got my sword Quindy trying to clog up this area. Trying to block off the general so he can't get to our ballista. They still have a lot of infantry over here. Look at this. They still have 2-3 units of infantry. And they've got the guards of Orthanc. They've got the catapult in a pretty good position. They're reloading it. You can see he's got berserkers over here. It's not a good sight. It's not a good situation for our elves. Here we go. Let's enjoy this shot right here. Let's see if he gets any good hits. Listen, every time they reloaded that catapult, me and Jackie Fish, we were just praying to the great Juju of the mountain that they would miss every single time. Unfortunately, he gets a hit there. It's not looking good for my archers. And at this point, I was trying to use up all my arrow fire before I used them as melee, but things were looking pretty bad. Oh, yeah, here comes the orcs. They're charging through. They're breaking through the lines. And now I have to get my men back into tight formation, and they have to hold against the spearmen who are charging through. Jackie Fish now sending down some archers who've used up most of their ammo, I assume. Oh, we're actually breaking them. Look at that. He pushed them too hard. The orcs are breaking. We're closing up the gaps once again. More arrows coming down. Trying to take out these Uruk raiders. Urukai raiders. Yeah, but this flank is completely lost. You can see there's no more defenders over here. All our elves have been evaporated. And really, it's down to this infantry force right here. Jackie Fish, he needs to send something over here. I need to send something. For now, my archers are going to continue to fire. And look at, we're trying to light this ballista on fire. You see how he pushed it so close over here? We're shooting fire arrows over here. They're coming in. That is awesome looking. And I'm also firing my ballista at this side. I just can't get a hit. I just cannot destroy these ballistas, so they're going to continue to sit here right in front of our face and continue to fire at our defenses. Not a good sight. Not a good situation. Also, he's got the catapult firing as well. So now we're sending in a lot of archers. Oh, the general trying to flank around. We just evaporated his bodyguard. So now it's just the general. But unfortunately, this is a general that his entire army is dead. So killing him is not really going to do a lot there. Oh, there he goes. He pushed over like a bunch of my elves. My own general. Look, he's standing over his body. It's like he killed him. So my general is like, "You orc scum," and spits on his body. So now we're holding with our archers who've used up most of their ammo. We've got a small group of elves doing the best they can over here. With my warriors, I'm trying to get them to fire at that ballista. They have two ballistas left. We lit one on fire. And they're trying to snipe out my ballista. Those bastards. So this is a battle of ballista right here. This is such an important moment. Because if we can't kill his artillery, there's no way we're going to win this battle. So I'm doing everything I can with the archers I have left over, using fire arrows, trying to light these suckers on fire. And now the guards of Orthanc are pushing in. So he's committing more forces. We zoom in here, we're still holding. Oh, here goes another volley. Oh, we're lighting some of the crew on fire, but we're not lighting the actual machines on fire. Oh, nope. No good, just can't get a hit. I was legit mad. I was like, why does the ballista never miss except when I'm using it? Why does that happen? More fire arrows going down in that position. Trying to defeat these raiders. Defeat seems certain so the elves can hold on. Oh god, that was so close. Oh, another good hit right there. Taking out about 5 elves there. Here comes the guards of Orthanc pushing in. I'm trying to focus down all my archer fire down at the guards of Orthanc at this position because they're really tough to kill and it's a very healthy unit, 148. Oh, more ballista fire coming in. Oh, jeez, that was so close. That could have been disaster. Oh, no. Took out like 15 elves there. And the ballista is now firing. And my ballista, I was just barely able to save my ballista from the guards of Orthanc. More catapult fire coming down. Just, oh, no, no. See, right there, just a lot of crispy elves. There's no way. There's no way now. The balance of power is still in favor. They've We've actually killed 1% more than they've killed of us. It is extremely close. Can we hold on? Can we win this battle? Or will the artillery just slaughter us all? We're just hoping they run out of ammo soon, but it doesn't seem like that's the case. They're still just focusing down this blob here of forces. We have a mid-defeat by one of the Mordor forces because we destroyed all of his army. Oh! Yes! Yes, we got a hit! One of the ballistas are on fire. We just have one more we have to take out. One more ballista, and that's going to save a lot of lives. Let's see if we can get it here. It's so close. I mean, I was just like, yes! I was so happy that we killed one of his ballistas. But of course, he still has his catapult, which seems to have a lot of ammo. Just never-ending ammo coming in. Oh, jeez. More elves. Look at that. How does he do it? I don't know. He just never hits his own troops. We broke the Isengard forces here. They're now breaking. My ballista's going at it again, trying to take out his ballista. Let's see if we can pull it off here. Oh, let's see. Nope. Nope. Just short. Just missed. A little too far to the left there. He needs to reposition. Needs to take it out. And I'm like, come on. Quickly kill him before they get another shot off. Please, hurry up. Oh, more catapults coming in. Just missing our elves over there that were recently victorious. Here we go. Come on, take it out. Take it out. He's so close to firing. Looks like he's changing targets. It's buying us time. Let's see, where is my ballista? Come on, are you going to reload? I think they stopped firing at this point. But my general right now, he's in the front lines. He's taking on the guards of Orthanc. I have no other option. I have to send in my general. Look, he's moving up. He's not too bloodied up, so he still has a lot of hit points. And our archers are still firing. Since they finish off those Isengard forces, they can now go back to firing their bows. The ballista crew, they ran out of ammo. So, unfortunately, I wasn't able to defeat or destroy that ballista, but they are out of ammo, so they're going to charge in the ballista crew. Oh, nice. Hitting his own men there. And now my Eldarinway archers are going to charge in. We got another general charging in. We got to take him out as well. It's going to be a big issue there. So this battle coming down to a handful of troops. You can see he's moving his catapult closer to the front line, which is really good because my ballista could get him. My ballista, I believe, is in range. Let's see. Do they have a shot? This ballista right here has a shot towards that catapult. We gotta take it out. That is our only hope. The balance of power is dead even at this point of the battle. Oh, so close. So close. And I was legit mad at that moment. I was just like, oh my god, why? We just can't get a lucky shot. We can't turn this battle around. And again, he still has a healthy unit of berserkers over there. There goes another shot. And again, he gets another ridiculous hit. Actually, both hits hit. Any kind of hit is bad because we need every single soul fighting here. And oh, again, we miss. We miss with the ballista. And he's going to go ahead and load up another shot. I mean, this was... like, I felt like one good artillery shot would have ended the battle. So every time we miss with the ballista, I just die inside. There goes another shot. And yes, we take out one of the catapults back there. Here comes the berserkers coming in. They're charging in through this gap. Jackyfish focusing down his archer fire. Now Jackyfish is going to charge in his general to close in that gap. So this is it. This is the moment of truth right here. Who will be victorious? The balance of power is, again, still even. And the catapult still alive, still reloading. Here comes another ballista shot just over the catapult. Will he be able to get another shot? Let's see. Let's see. Miss, miss. Come on. Oh, he's reloading. He's changing targets. Whenever you do that, you have to completely reload the catapult and boom, it's gone. Fantastic. We took out his artillery and the day, there's still a chance. We can still save the day here. But we gotta take out these berserkers. If we don't take them out, obviously they'll just cut through our forces. You can see Jackyfish doing something really wise over here. He has his Sylvan Heavy archers firing from the flank because they're better off killing the berserkers from afar than actually trying to fight them. And you can see they actually sent in the general. He was going to try to silence my ballista crew, but it really doesn't matter because I don't have any good angles to the enemy forces. So I told my ballista crew to stop using the ballista and support the front line and try to take out these berserkers. I know that's something you don't want to hear as a ballista crew, like, oh, you got to give up the ballista and go go into melee against berserkers. Like, what? Oh, there goes the general. Archers took him out. That's all right. Not a huge moment right there because it's really just down to Isengard forces. The general is in this unit right here, in the berserker unit. You can see Jacketfish's general right there. He's getting pretty bloodied over there. He's in the front line. My general, he's in the front line as well. Yep, he's pretty bloodied as well. There he is. I need him to stay alive. He's got to get some kills here while we watch him. You know, it looks more awesome. Let's see. Come on, get a kill. Come on. I know you're moving in for the kill. Come on. He's just watching. He's like, yeah, get him. I've got a lone warrior archer here. The balance of power is now shifting in our favor. And things are looking better and better. Taking on the catapult crew here. Down to one guy here. The berserkers are surrounded. The sentinels of the woodland realm, they're doing a good job. Continuing to fire at the flank. We finally killed the catapult crew. So I'm going to turn my archers around. I'm going to fire at the flank of the other side of the berserkers. Now the guards of Orthanc are breaking. It is a pleasant sight indeed. The balance of power is way in our favor. So it looks like we are going to come out with victory. But you never know. We could someone's general could die. There could be a massive chain rout. It's not likely because all he's down to is 22 berserkers. But this is hilarious. I wanted to show you this. This is crazy. So you got this one warrior archer, and he's just having a field day over here. He's shooting down retreating forces. Look at this. There's one guy left, and he's shooting him down. Let's see if he can get him. That would be insane if he could actually kill this guy. You can see, oh, there's his arrow. Nope, short. Come on, dude. Use your elven eyes. It's kind of like Game of Thrones, beginning of the Battle of Bastards. Just trying to gun down this guy here. Here comes another volley. Come on. There he goes. Oh, that was closer. It's not super close. I probably should have told him to switch to standard shot. Much better odds of killing him. He doesn't kill him, though, unfortunately. And this is what's left here of these orcs. You can see the general is fighting with his berserkers. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is going to conclude today's epic Elven Alliance last stand. And the berserkers, they're putting up a great stand here, but they're not going to have enough troops to seize victory. There goes the general. Oh, that poor elf over there is dying, though. Rest in peace. You almost survived the battle. Oh, what a fight. Just what a crazy fight. All over the place. It was in the front lines over here, down in the valley. We had to retreat because there's no way we could have, you know, held all those defensive positions. And, that concludes today's battle. You can see me and Jackyfish, we ended with pretty much the same amount of troops. Jackyfish killed a bit more than me. He killed 4,456. He did a great job over that choke point way up here on this very thin choke point. And then I got 3,714. So very tough fight. If you look at the kills here, of course, Isengard did the best. It's just because Isengard's just a better faction. But good game to all the players here. It was really, really fun. Looking at my kills, 451 for my Eldarin Way archers. No surprise there that my archers got the most kills. Without a doubt, 360 by my spearmen, which is pretty good. Probably mostly killing orc band. But yeah, that concludes today's battle. This was kind of like inspiration by the new DLC for Warhammer. It's the Wood Elves. They're releasing them the 8th of December. So I was like, you know what? Why don't we do an epic elven last stand against a horde of orcs? I think that would be awesome. Maybe we can try to recreate this battle in Warhammer when we actually get the elves. I think that would be a lot of fun. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this battle. It was really, really fun. If you did enjoy, be sure to leave a like, a comment, share, and of course subscribe for more epic battles. Thanks guys so much, and I will see you next time.